Sri K. Somaprasad ji.
Thank you, sir.
The banning of unregulated depository schemes bill 2019 is a comprehensive law, sir. It is high time to enact such a law in the country. Sir, I think this will help to tackle the menace of illicit deposit taking activities in the country. It would legally ban the unregulated deposit activities, taking activities. There are a lot of cheating cases related to the unregulated deposit schemes by fraud deposit takers. Most of the time, poor people are the victims of such fraud and cheating. Sir, the non-banking entities are allowed to raise deposits from public under the provisions of various statutes enacted by the central and state governments. However, the regulatory framework for deposit taking activity in the country is not seamless. The Ponzi schemes, that is, fraudulent investing scam promising higher rates of return to the investors, are still operating in the society. This bill will put an end to this illegal practice, I think so. As we know, the law creates three types of offences, that is, running of unregulated deposit scheme, fraudulent default in regulated deposit schemes, and wrongful inducement in relation to unregulated deposit scheme. The bill provides deterrent punishment for promoting or operating on unregulated deposit taking schemes, and also provides punishment for fraudulent default in repayment to deposits. All are good and appreciable, sir, but I agree with most of the proposals in the bill. But at the same time, there is an apprehension that the law is extremely harsh and it will lead to hardship for many individuals, especially small business community in the village level. There are certain uncertainty in the law. The Act defines deposit taker and unregulated deposit schemes, but it does not define the unregulated deposit. It is left for the interpretation. It would allow open-ended and subjective decisions of the authorities while adjudicating the offences related to depositors. Hence, the unregulated deposit be more coherently defined and listed in a schedule in the bill. The government says that there is no ban in borrowing money for taking loan or taking loan for personal usage. But there is an ambiguity in the law. In case of loans taken by individuals, in section 24F, only exempts loan from relatives or amounts received by a firm from relatives of the partners. That is, the exemption applies to the loans only from the relatives. There is no explicit exemption for loans from non-relatives. Sir, if a person accepts a loan from his friend due to some family, sir, just have a minute. If a family from emergency or there is a medical need of fund for the personal reasons, such acceptance of loans or deposit are not exempted by the present bill. There must be clarity and there should be a clear-cut provision for the exemption of such loans, sir. As far as the real estate area is concerned, the exemption does not include any advance with the refund provision. Thus, a home buyer, after giving an advance to a builder, may not be able to claim refund if the builder fails to deliver the house. Here also, specific provisions should be incorporated, sir. My suggestion is that the government should organize maximum publicity about this bill, especially in the rural area. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Somaprasad ji.